Greetings, friends. David Marks here. Have you ever wanted to edit a photo that you shot with your smartphone using the Lightroom for iOS or Android app without importing? Well, now you can do this with ease. With this update, we can now use the Lightroom for Mobile app as an image browser to quickly scroll through all of the photos that are stored on your phone. In browsing mode, when you find a photo that you like, then you can immediately begin to edit it without wasting any time. This new feature is a real time saver when you just want to shoot, edit, and go. Let me hop over to my iPad and I'll show you what I mean. With the latest update, you might have noticed that things look a little different whenever you launch the mobile app. If you've updated recently, then you might have noticed that all of the old photos that you'd imported or synced over from your desktop computer, those images now appear to be missing. Don't panic. I promise your older images are fine. They've just been moved to a different tab. I'll show you how to get to the older stuff in a second, but first, let's stick with what's new. Right now, what you're seeing is the new device or gallery browser mode. And in here, you should be able to see all of the images that you've captured recently using this smartphone or tablet. As you scroll up or down, you should be able to parse through all of the photos that you currently have on this device's camera roll. Once you've found an image that you want to edit, then you can select it with a single finger tap. And with one more tap, you can begin to edit this photo right away. This may not seem like a big deal, but this is a much faster way to access Lightroom's amazing editing tools without wasting time importing a whole bunch of other images that you don't need right now. To keep this demo moving as fast as possible, I'm going to tap on the auto button so that Lightroom will change the brightness of this image for me. Next, I'm going to apply one of the recommended presets to this photograph. And finally, I'm going to add an AI-powered mask to brighten up that foreground a little bit more. Now, the mask I'm adding at first is going to select the sky, but when I tap this button here, I can invert it so that now we have the foreground. Next, I'll make the foreground a little bit brighter, and maybe I'll bring out the shadows a little more, and I think I'll also add a little texture and clarity. Okay. Now I'll hit done, and in no time, we've gone from this to this, and I'm happy. When I'm done working on this image, I can tap the back button. That's this little arrow up here at the top left, and instantly, a copy of my enhanced image will be automatically saved back into my Lightroom library. I'll show you how to find that enhanced copy in just a second, but first, do you see this new badge here? This little LR symbol with the pencil icon. This new icon indicates that there's now an edited copy of this photo within my Lightroom library and an unedited copy still out there in the device's camera roll. This little icon makes it easier for me to tell which photos I have and which images I have not edited yet when I'm scrolling around in browser mode. To chase down the enhanced version that I just created and to find all of my old images, I can tap on the Lightroom Library icon right down here in the middle at the bottom center of the screen. Now, you can see that this new photo has indeed been added in with all the others. When we're back to the Library tab, when this is the mode that we're using, now the app's home screen looks much like it has for the past 5 years or so. The only thing that's different here is that I was able to completely skip the traditional import process before I got to work on this one. Before you get the wrong idea, let me point out that this direct browse feature is great when we want to edit one photo at a time. But the import command, that little picture with the plus on it in the blue pill-shaped button, that command is still super helpful when you want to bring in a batch of files all at once. Now that you understand the new user interface, Let me show you one more example of how fast and easy it is to use this new feature. If there's an image that I want to edit and that's not already in my library, then all I have to do is to tap on the device icon at the bottom left. Oh, Android users, the button that I just tapped is labeled Gallery on your screen. The names of these icons are different in the iOS versus Android platform, but other than that, they're the same. Next, I can find the image that I want. In this case, I made it easy for myself because I marked the one that I want as a favorite. Once I've found the image that I want, I can select it with a tap, and then I can immediately begin to edit it. For this demo, I'm going to use the auto button again to set the overall brightness. I'll open up the color tab, and I'll improve the white balance. I'll open up the crop tab, and I'll crop this one as a square. And finally, I'm going to add some portrait refinements using Lightroom's AI-powered masking tools and its adaptive presets. From this to this in no time. And when I'm happy, I can tap on the share button and I can attach a copy of this to an email for instant delivery. Well, there you go. I hope that you found this video helpful. If you learned something today, then please hit the subscribe button and leave us a like or a comment down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in our next tutorial.